Welcome to the beautiful island of Tobago for the 29th running of the Tobago International Cycling Classic, featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. Hello everyone, I'm Mark Brown, along with Ronald Dickey. And Ronald, this is the Caribbean's premier cycling event. Nobody knows this better than you, as a former champ of the U23 and the King of the Mountains here. What makes this event so special?
Well, it's 5 days of racing in the brutal hot sun.
And Tobago's climbs are some of the toughest around. The riders will be tested for endurance and their technical ability. In addition to the road racing, we have 3 stages of mountain biking through the rainforest of Tobago.
The 2015 Tobago International Cycling Classic begins now. There is so much cycling taking place during this event in Tobago, and it's really 3 distinct events that make up the week. First, there's the Classic, a 4-stage omnium through the streets of Tobago. Meanwhile, on the mountains and through the rainforest, we have a 3-stage mountain biking race. And finally, we have a 1-day UCI-sanctioned road race, the Tour of Tobago, which brings our riders completely around the island. This race is the first race on the 2016 UCI Americas calendar, so valuable UCI points are on the line. Premier riders from around the world are here, and we've got participants from Germany, Denmark, New Zealand, the United States, Colombia, Venezuela, and of course, the Caribbean. The 3-time defending champ of the Tour of Tobago is Team Cocos, and they've returned 2012 and 2013 champions Darren Matthews of Barbados and Jaime Ramirez of Colombia as they attempt a 4th straight title. But for Matthews, just getting his team here has been a challenge.
This last week has been probably one of the most stressful weeks of my life. For me to leave Colombia, I had to get a yellow fever vaccine, and I missed 3 flights. Just trying to get everything sorted because they refused to let me leave the country.
Team Cocos como tal tiene el objetivo principal. Siempre trabajamos todo el año para llegar bien a esta carrera y con mi compañero Darren Matthews y por lo general estamos trabajando en un 100% pensando en esta carrera todo el tiempo.
But standing in their way is Team Foundation, made up of a strong Dominican contingent. Rafael Moran is always a threat, and last year, Adderlin Felix Cruz proved equally dangerous, missing out on the top spot by the narrowest of margins in a sprint finish to Oscar Pachon of Team Cocos.
Este año vinimos el equipo con el objetivo de ganar el evento, ganar el criterium, y la UCI vengo muy preparado, y espero ganar la carrera.
Yo pienso que tenemos un gran equipo. El equipo está bien conformado. Tenemos corredores tanto dominicanos, colombianos, como de Trinidad y Tobago también. Y nos tratamos como una familia. Siempre damos lo mejor de sí, cada quien hace su aporte. Y estamos muy contentos con el trabajo de cada uno en el equipo.
When we return, it's stage one of the Tobago International Cycling Classic.
Next one, right there.
The 4-stage omnium that kicks off an exciting week of cycling here in the Caribbean.
Hold on, let it come.
This program is being brought to you by the Tobago House of Assembly, the Tourism Development Company of Trinidad and Tobago, and the Magdalena Grand Beach and Golf Resort. For more, check us out on your favorite social media.
You're in Tobago. Relax.
Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit GoTrinidadAndTobago.com.
Trinidad and Tobago, two unique islands, two unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago. Experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
Welcome back. Stage one of the Tobago International Cycling Classic kicked off a week-long event. 100 riders from 29 different countries made up the Division One field. Stage one was 10 laps, equaling 110 kilometers in full. Riders accumulate points for first through 20th place, with aggregate point total determining the yellow jersey. Each 11-kilometer lap, relatively flat with just a gradual climb at the 7-kilometer point. Go. And with that, the 2015 Tobago International Cycling Classic was underway. We saw several short-lived breaks in the early laps, and a couple of riders go down midway through lap 5. Jamal Eastman of Barbados was among them. Riders tried to stay cool in the blistering heat as Team Crown Bakery Knights FR manager Pete Sue kept the drinks flowing in the feed zone.
Next one, right there.
It wasn't until lap 6 where a 4-man break showed some staying power. As was the case in earlier breaks, Team Cocos and Team Foundation were in the mix. For Cocos, it was 2012 champ Darren Matthews and Adderlin Felix Cruz of Foundation. The break lasted for 3 laps. But like the other breaks, this one too was reeled in. And amazingly, over the last lap and a half, the entire group came back together at the front, setting up what looked to be a bunch sprint at the finish. Then halfway through the last lap, Germany's Henner Rodel of Team Crown Bakery Knights FR made a big move. He distanced himself from the rest of the pack and made a desperate attempt to outlast them to the finish. Henner Rodel's advantage is disappearing by the pedal stroke. 200 meters to go. Rodel bravely trying to hold off the surging peloton, and here comes Foundation's Normandy Sanchez Tavera, beats Rodel at the line for the Stage 1 victory. It was Team Foundation's Normandy Sanchez Tavera sprinting to the stage win, with Rodel finishing second and Jamaica's Marlo Rodman of Team PSL taking third. However, in the frantic sprint finish, a nasty crash sent Foundation's Rafael Moran and Team Breakaway's Stefan Christensen flying off the road. Both riders eventually picked themselves up, but would be doubtful for future stages. We would learn later that Moran suffered a broken left wrist, and once both riders were up, I had a chance to speak to the winner, Foundation's Normandy Sanchez Tavera.
Congratulations, it was an incredible sprint at the end. Did you think you'd be able to catch Rodel and win the race?
Felicidades, fue un sprint muy cercano, y ellos quieren saber si tú eras capaz de agarrar al muchacho que estaba escapado al final.
En un momento pensé que no, pero cuando salió el sprint lo vi cerca y ahí ya tuve que dar todo por el todo y sí logré alcanzarlo.
Hard work paid off for Normandy today, but this week is so much more than just cycling. The third member of our team is Ashley Abaksh, and she found the fun at Pigeon Point.
Basically, take your paddle, put it behind. This is a circle from the front to this middle area here.
When you come to Tobago, probably the most fun you're going to have is on the water. And today we're here with Dwayne Kenny. He's from Stand Up Paddle Tobago. And we also have Patrick Erickson and also Tyler Locke. And they are two riders, and we are going to have some fun today on the water. Are you all ready, guys?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, you got it. Bend your knees. Paddle, get paddle in the water, get paddle in the water. Also, the paddle was behind, so you want to have it in front.
Yeah. So, Dwayne,
y'all did fantastic.
But I fell kind of sort of twice though.
Well, you know, you got to start somewhere and you work your way up, and before you know it, in an hour, you're a pro.
And you're seeing a lot of people getting into the water sports, of course, right here in Pigeon Point.
Definitely. Kite surfing, windsurfing, sauna paddling, snorkeling, all the good stuff. So yeah, once you're in the sea, life is better.
When we return, it's stage two of the Tobago International Cycling Classic, and our riders get to test their legs on the tough climbs of Tobago and get a taste of the dangerous descents.
You're in Tobago. Relax. Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit gotrinidadandtobago.com. Trinidad and Tobago, two unique islands, two unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago, experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
Welcome back to the 2015 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. Later in the show, we'll give you a look at the mountain biking event, but first, our road cyclists have some mountains of their own to tackle in stage two. Four laps totaling 100 kilometers with hardly a flat spot on the course. Three big climbs on each of those laps total 12 climbs in the stage. You're either climbing or descending.
Good luck, guys. Let's have a good race. Good luck. Let's go.
There was a four-man breakaway in lap one, which included Canadian James Piccoli of Team PSL, Team Venezuela's Herbert Rivas, Colombian Alirio Martinez of Team Luna, and Denmark's Daniel Bligard-Line of Team Breakaway. No sign of our yellow jersey holder, Norlandy Sanchez-Tavera, among the leaders. Norlandy of Team Foundation also missing his teammate Rafael Moran, who did not start stage two as he fractured his wrist after that big crash at the end of stage one. Early in lap three, Team Venezuela's Freddy Vargas and then New Zealand rider Tim Rush of PSL joined the leaders. Then on the final descent of the lap, Vargas made a big move to break away. He created a gap of 45 seconds before failing to negotiate a tight corner and flying over his handlebars. He didn't seem to realize that a stone had lodged into his helmet, but it didn't seem to faze him, losing little time despite the fall.
Stone here.
Meanwhile, Dominican rider Adderlin Felix Cruz of Team Foundation and Cuba's Vicente Sanabria of the Braves joined the chase group. But Vargas continued to widen his gap on the fourth and final lap and finished strong, winning stage two by nearly 3 minutes.
Here comes the winner of the second stage.
Freddy Vargas spoke about his fall late in lap three.
Sí, en el momento que yo he atacado, pues creo que he empezado a bajar muy rápido y una de las curvas me sorprendió y ya he pasado derecho para y me he caído, pero gracias a Dios y a la Virgen, pues no me pasó nada grave y pude volver a retomar la bicicleta y seguir adelante.
Our yellow jersey holder, Norlandy Sanchez Tavera of Team Foundation, abandoned in the early part of the stage. And with that, Marlo Rodman of Jamaica and TPSL took over the yellow. I caught up with a Jamaican rider, not normally known for his climbing ability.
I did a little bit of hill training, so it worked out really well. I was suffering for the last two laps, and the climbers went away. Each lap, they went away, and I just, you know, keep a tempo, and I caught them down the descent, and it worked out perfect.
One of the most unique parts of this event occurs between stages 2 and 3. Ashley Abaksh has more.
After 2 stages of the Tobago International Cycling Classic, there is a day off. And on this day, the riders get a chance to relax and enjoy Pigeon Point and the Rum Punch Party.
We have an event on the beach where we have a Rum Punch Party. I think the only place in the world where that happens.
Estoy en la fiesta de ron, muy divertida. Bailamos, se hacen competencias también. So es muy divertida aquí esta fiesta.
I'm Christian Akona from Lienz in Austria, and I live here for 15 years now. I'm supporting many, many teams every year. I don't care which nation, I support everybody. And I love the Rum Party. The Rum Party is the best in the world here.
One of the things that's really great about this event is they made a day to say, you guys have all suffered the heat, you've suffered the hills, come just have fun with one another.
The Rum Punch Festival serves as an area for us to interact with the cyclists. It's a way to make them feel a part of Tobago, make them appreciate our culture a little bit. So we try to integrate our culture through our music and our food.
The doubles is a special hand food. There is two bread-like parts that we call the barra that you use, and you have the curry chana in the middle. And you have one side and you dip it in. This is something that you can use a knife and fork for. It's a hand food and so delicious.
Limbo, limbo. How low can you go? Everybody wants to know. Come on and limbo, limbo.
TNT is the home of the limbo. This is where it was born. This is where it came from. It originated here. We love it. We do it at every party and we just get it on.
You have to have a strong abs, back tags, and you really have to work on the training. Limbo actually originates from Trinidad, and it also relates to the carnival aspect of Trinidad and Tobago.
When we return, mountain biking. Plus, stage 3 and 4 of the Tobago International Cycling Classic. 2 crit races that will put speed on display. And speaking of speed, we'll show you another event that is all about speed. And later, it's the featured UCI Tour of Tobago.
You're in Tobago. Relax. Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit gotrinidadandtobago.com. Trinidad and Tobago, 2 unique islands, 2 unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago. Experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
Welcome back to the 2015 Tobago International Cycling Classic, featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. Stages 3 and 4 of the Classic are all about speed, and two of this year's riders know plenty about that. Ashley Abaksh has more.
One of Trinidad and Tobago's most popular sporting events is the annual Great Race. It is actually the longest running powerboat race in the world. It started in 1969, spans 86 miles off the coast of Trinidad, and finishes right here in Tobago.
My name is Guy Costa. I'm riding with Heatwave Cycle Club. In the last 5 years, there's been a big resurgence in offshore powerboat racing in Trinidad, and we're now on a par with anywhere else in the world. The name of the boat is Fire One. But I am the throttle man, and James Hadid is the driver.
It's definitely a collaboration between the two guys. We need to move in sync, and it takes sometimes a couple of years and a lot of races before the sync is 100%. Lots of guys who have raced for many, many years have never won it. Fortunately, we have won the Great Race twice.
One of the main attractions for offshore races is the fact that you're never really 100% in control of what's happening. You're on a moving track. The sea is always changing. It's scary, I mean, but then that's what we kind of seem to thrive on, being scared.
It can be scary at times, but that's what we love.
The speed continued on the roads, and our yellow jersey belonged to Jamaica's Marlo Rodman of Team PSL. Did he have the speed to get the job done in stage three? It sure looked like it as he sprinted out to the front very early in the Plymouth Criterium. A four-man group lapped the peloton about halfway through the race, and for the next 25 laps, it was just those four riders competing for the stage win. Rodman, Team Coco's Darren Matthews, Dominican Rafael Moran of Team Foundation, riding with a broken wrist, and Frenchman Mathieu Jeans of Team Lupus. On lap 33, Moran and Tobago's Emile Abraham got tangled up on turn one and hit the pavement. Within the rules, Moran was allowed a free lap and was able to stay among the lead group, while Abraham abandoned the stage. And it was a flat-out sprint to the finish, with Rodman taking first to retain the yellow, Moran took second, Matthews third, and Johns fourth. Going into the fourth and final stage, Marlo Rodman had to finish seventh or better in order to win the 2015 Tobago International Cycling Classic. Meanwhile, the TICC Mountain Biking Classic was taking place.
Stage one, it was six laps, basically a sprint.
The first race was really nice. It was quick, it was technical, it was fast, and it was laps. So you kind of knew, okay, pace myself. All right, last lap, let's go, let's go.
Stage two, it was a little bit tougher with the hills. Today was one of the toughest races. We did the course in reverse with the added-on extension. The hills were pretty tough, mainly a lot of climbing.
Today was amazing. It was really tough. I had like two issues. I crashed out in one downhill. My chain slipped. So it happens as mountain biking. You never know what to expect. All you have to do is hope that you finish your race. I'm glad I came. I will be back next year. So whip some more guys' butts.
Back to the roads in the final stage of the Classic, taking place in Scarborough. Marlo Rodman was wearing the yellow jersey, but among those with a shot to steal it was stage one winner, number 82, Norlandy Sanchez Tavera, and stage one runner-up, number 25, Henner Rodel of Team Crown Bakery Knights FR. The 60-lap race was hotly contested, and Team Foundation did a solid job of getting their riders to the front, keeping Sanchez Tavera in the bunch, making sure he had the legs to the end. Meanwhile, Team PSL rode in control, knowing that Rodman didn't need to win to capture yellow. PSL's Nick Stoppler went to the front with three laps to go and paced, making sure he had his teammate Rodman with him. With Stoppler leading out, Rodman was in perfect position for the sprint finish. In that finish, it was Normandy Sanchez Tavera out kicking everyone for his second stage win of the Classic. Darren Matthews finished second, and Rodman captured third, and the yellow jersey by the slimmest of margins. Just an 8-point edge in the end. Here's a look at the Stage 4 results. And the overall final standings for the four-stage Tobago International Cycling Classic with Rodman on top. The final sprint results, the Jamaican Rodman also taking the top spot. Rodman knew there were only two riders he needed to worry about.
Just stay too close to the guy in 82 and 25. Those guys were the closest to me. My teammate just saying, just stay close to the front and mark those guys and I'll be okay. And that's exactly what I did. So I know if I finish in the top seven, I'll be okay.
When we return, it's the highly anticipated 2015 UCI 1.2 Tour of Tobago. This program is being brought to you by the Tobago House of Assembly, the Tourism Development Company of Trinidad and Tobago, and the Magdalena Grand Beach and Golf Resort. For more, check us out on your favorite social media.
You're in Tobago. Relax. Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit gotrinidadandtobago.com. Trinidad and Tobago, two unique islands, two unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago, experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
It's time for the 2015 UCI 1.2 Tour of Tobago. Departing from Scarborough, Ashley Abaksh has more.
Scarborough is the heartbeat of the island, its largest city and capital of Tobago. Visitors can enjoy strolling through the botanical gardens, shopping at the Scarborough Market, and even visiting Fort King George.
Thanks, Ash. The Tour of Tobago circumnavigates the entire island, 120 kilometers in full.
Okay, cyclists, be safe, good luck, enjoy the race. Let's go.
The 2015 UCI Tour of Tobago is underway, leaving the streets of Scarborough on a huge ride, circuiting the entire island of Tobago with all of its steep and vicious climbs and harrowing descents. Ronald Dickey, you've ridden this race many, many times. What's in store for the riders today?
A lot of mountains are in store for the riders today. As we know, as we come out of Scarborough, there is a climb already, just a slight incline. But the riders are rushing, trying to get to the front, trying to get their team leaders to that first climb by Bard Hill. It's completely flat before we start to go up into the climb. So when we get into the mountains, there's no way out.
Amazingly, there is a little bit of action off the front. Three men have come off the front and a chaser as well, and there is a gap to the peloton. Interesting move this early. Crazy, perhaps?
A little bit crazy, I think, for the riders, knowing that they're coming into the mountains. But you could see young Campbell for PSL. He's more of a track guy, and it's his first big international stage, so he might be trying to reach the mountains first before anyone could catch him.
And normally what we would get would be
attacks once we hit the real climbs, and oftentimes those can be definitive as far as separating those that have a chance to win and the rest of the field. Normally you don't see a separation here that lasts the length of the day in the Tour of Tobago. So as we come through the roundabout at Auchincloss Road by the Republic Bank, we are now all back together again with a Red Vangen Union rider remaining on the front. Now a quick look over his shoulder to see who has rejoined them. It was Herman Keller that was sparking that break. He now sits up in the saddle, and Plan B will come into effect. Meanwhile, a PSL rider, Alex Bogal, coming up off the right side of the group. Left side of your screen seems to have a move in mind. A little chatter within the peloton to see whether anyone is thinking about going on the hunt for him, but for now, he's being allowed to get a gap. Well, it's been a lovely ride for the first about 15 kilometers for Canadian Alex Bogal from Team PSL. He has had a successful breakaway, but as the roads straighten out, he is able to look back and find three chasers chasing him. Right now, not quite in their sights, but very soon, this is going to turn into an uphill climb as we move towards Bad Hill.
We are approaching Bad Hill itself. And we checked the climb and the altimeter of these climbs in the first set, and it goes up to the second highest peak all day long, and it's still not a categorized climb.
Yeah, 17 total kilometers of climbing, and very, very difficult. It will separate a number of the riders for sure, a big part of the field, and then the categorized climbs kick in. We look back down the road, and you do see two chasers and another one coming around that S formation back there. So there are chasers who are trying to link up with Bogal. And now, just coming around that corner, is the entire peloton. We'll see how Bogal handles this first climb. Welcome to the Tour of Tobago.
This event happening in Tobago, with the indoor velodrome happening in Trinidad, you know, pretty soon we are going to become the cycling capital of the Caribbean.
Trinidad and Tobago is a destination not only for sport, tourism, but for leisure as well.
Apart from the cycling, Tobago is blessed with a number of really, really great beaches, fantastic scuba diving. I myself am a scuba diver, and Tobago is one of my favorite dive destinations.
Tobago is perfect for holiday. Tobago is paradise.
You're in Tobago. Relax. Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit gotrinidadandtobago.com. Trinidad and Tobago, two unique islands, two unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago. Experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
As we continue up this long, uncategorized climb, the first real test for these riders in the UCI Tour of Tobago right now, Alex Bogal is passing those tests, but just over his shoulder and in our camera view at the moment, not only a chaser, it looks like the entire peloton. So at 20 kilometers in, the peloton has caught the escape of Alex Bogal. And now Red Vangen Union has the front of the peloton Looks like it's Herman Keller leading the way. Definitely Team Venezuela in there in second position. We see three or four Cocos riders in the first 15 positions. Still inside the first 30 kilometers, and we're in that part of the race of the Tour of Tobago where the riders have been climbing for quite some time. Not a categorized climb, but very difficult. They're all together. What do you think of the makeup of the front of that peloton?
Well, it's amazing. I've never seen a peloton come across this climb, especially all together like this, which you see a lot of the riders, they have that form, that climbing ability, and they're here to win the Tour. We have 60-plus riders coming up this first climb still, but remember, we still have Englishman's Bay to come, so the riders will get separated. We will see the sheep from the goat when we go into those mountains in the end.
Absolutely, and we may see some sheep and goats on the ride as well. We'll try to avoid them. They're all over the place.
So with this long climb about ready to peak, our riders will descend into the town of Castara. Ashley Abaksh is there now getting some local knowledge.
We're with Javon, and he's one of the locals, born and grown right here in Castara. Javon, what is unique about Castara?
What is unique about Castara is that Castara has a lovely beach, a lovely waterfall, some of the most kind-hearted and honest people that you can find throughout the whole island. And there's also a lovely bakery. There's fresh fish. You can't go wrong. Castara is paradise.
So at the 36-kilometer mark, 84 kilometers from the finish, it's a large contingent of riders at the front. They descend into Castara on the beautiful leeward coast of Tobago. Right now, a spectacular view of Castara Bay on their left. As they start now coming into town, Team Breakaway has Jesper Hansen of Denmark leading the group, and Darren Matthews there, right on his wheel. The rest of the group in hot pursuit. Typically, we see just a handful of riders at the front in Castara. However, this year, a very large group making their way through this beautiful seaside village on the way to some short, punchy hills coming up.
And Team Cocos still showing dominance on the front. Darren Matthews has been doing a whole lot of work at the front of this group. He's got Jaime Ramirez on his wheel and another Cocos rider, Mauricio Orozco, in third position. Adderley Cruz is in there as well. Adderley Felix Cruz. He's wearing a different uniform today. He's riding for Team Foundation B. He finished second last year in this event, the Tour of Tobago, and he is in fourth position, right behind the three Cocos riders and just in front of a fourth. We're at Little Englishman's Bay with that beautiful rock formation protruding out in the middle. The leaders of the peloton racing by Little Englishman's Bay before heading up on a steep slope here. The entire Cocos team, it seems, is up on the front. Our first look at Reynolds Jeffries, who is now doing his turn to help the pace. Also, the light blue of Crown Bakery Knights, they're showing themselves. I don't see PSL on the front of this group, and as you can see, this has become a little bit more of a select group. This is not the entire peloton. And now coming up on the outside, Marlo Rodman for PSL, just as we've called out that team, deciding he is going to come forward again and begin doing tempo on the front. So we've had a bit of a selection here before the first categorized climb, and now Marlo Rodman soloing off the front a little bit, lifting the pace.
A look at Glasgow Pub overlooking Parletuvier Bay as our riders get ready to descend into Parletuvier before a big categorized climb. Thibaut Johns of Crown Bakery Knights FR leading the group down this descent. About 24 riders still very much a part of this group up front. We see Matthews and Team Cocos riding strong. Adderlin Felix Cruz of Foundation and Vicente Sanabria of Team Braves are right in there as well. And some of our great volunteers directing that traffic down in the village of Parletuvier. They guide those riders to their right at the start.
So we've now begun the Parletuvier climb. The select group of about 24 riders were all together, but we have a move. It is Adderley Felix Cruz, a man we expected a lot of good things from, the second categorized climb, the Parletuvier climb. He is now breaking away from that elite group and looking to go on his own. He is also taking on an escape partner as well in that one from the light blue team of Crown Bakery. Okay, so lots going on the Parletuvier climb. This is Vicente Sanabria who has now come up to take the lead on this attack. He and Adderley Felix Cruz may be working together here as Thibaut Janus was stopped momentarily and dropped from this group. We'll see if he can make it back. We're still going uphill, but this is a longer, more gradual uphill drag here at the moment and some feeding going on for these riders. So it's Sanabria and the yellow and the light blue, and in the darker blue with the white is Adderley Felix Cruz. Cruz finished second here at the Tour of Tobago a year ago, the year that Oscar Pachon won it, and they've gotten themselves a pretty decent gap on that group of about two dozen elite riders who are also well ahead of the peloton, which has been dropped several kilometers back. And this is the chasing group, selected down now to maybe 20 riders. Team Cocos is still in this group. Reinolf Jeffries right now in charge of leading the chase of this group. Back up with the leaders as they go up the Parletuvier climb. They are still a few hundred meters from the top of it, but have themselves a significant gap over their chasers. Two lead riders making their descent down from the Parletuvier climb down towards Bloody Bay on the Caribbean side of this beautiful island of Tobago. Now, Ronald, some riders really are tremendous descenders. Others are not. Sanabria is losing time in the descent here to Cruz.
Yeah, he's losing a lot of time. You can see he's not comfortable as he almost loses his back wheel right there as he came around that turn. And Cruz is just flying going down this climb, and he's making up a lot of time. But is it too early for Cruz to go all the way on his own?
That's a really good question. We're not even halfway through as we swing by Bloody Bay, beautiful beach facility, and move on away from the coastline for a bit.
This program is being brought to you by the Tobago House of Assembly, the Tourism Development Company of Trinidad and Tobago, and the Magdalena Grand Beach and Golf Resort. For more, check us out on your favorite social media.
You're in Tobago. Relax. Or get amped up with an amazing selection of tours to cater to just about anyone. Take the ferry over to Trinidad, shop, or take in the lush rainforest. Come and enjoy our rich cultural heritage and stunning coastline with daily flights from 9 international cities. For a holiday experience like never before, visit gotrinidadandtobago.com. Trinidad and Tobago, two unique islands, two unique experiences.
In 2016, the Tobago International Cycling Classic celebrates its 30th year. Beautiful vistas, savage climbs, and technical descents make up a race like no other. World-class cycling and Tobago-style fun and festivities. Book your tickets now for the 2016 Tobago International Cycling Classic featuring the UCI Tour of Tobago. September 27th through October 2nd.
Tobago. Experience the living culture of the true unspoiled Caribbean.
Welcome back to the 2015 UCI Tour of Tobago.
You can see some team cars coming up looking to provide some drinks on board for a tough climb and a very long day. Comfortably and up out of the saddle is Felix Cruz, but just look how quickly Sanabria is able to match that, and soon he'll be rejoining him. So Ronald, on the Parlatouvier descent, Felix Cruz used those descending skills to create a gap and then did ride away for a bit up the climb. Does it make more sense for him to do that and try to get those gaps, or maybe find a partner in Sanabria?
Well, it would be good if he could find a partner in Sanabria, but again, it's very long. It's a long wheel. Sanabria was in this same position last year. He was on the climb. He was looking very strong indeed. But again, the heat, as you come through this part, and the humidity at 77%, it's going to take a toll on the riders, but they have a marginable gap, and they might be able to stay away as much. But what's going to happen, the main chasers will have to use extra energy to close that gap, whereby, you know, the leaders just have to control as much as they can.
Cruz and Sanabria continuing to climb their way up the third KOM of the day, the climb to Lance Fourmi. Cruz taking the last KOM at Parlatouvier. Meanwhile, our chase group about 50 seconds behind Cruz and Sanabria as they enter the town of Lance Fourmi. But Jaime Ramirez of Team Cocos now attempting to bridge the gap, and he's making up ground quickly. Daniel Bligard Line and Tim Rush just trying to stay with the chasers.
Jaime Ramirez, the Tour of Tobago champion in 2013. He got himself on a continental team following that and was traveling the world in those competitions and did not return to defend in 2014. But here he is on good form in 2015, and he has caught the two leaders, Cruz and Sanabria. So three men ahead of the Tour of Tobago right now. A very nice group. Cruz from the Dominican Republic. Sanabria, the veteran, over 40 years old, from Cuba. And Jaime Ramirez, right in the prime of his cycling career, from Colombia. So the three-man escape group may be getting some company soon. A Team Venezuela rider trying to bridge the gap. That is rider number 142, Herbert Rivas. So as we let the four leaders by, we're heading down to probably the most dangerous and exciting descents in the Tour of Tobago. This is the headlong plunge into Charlottesville and Man O' War Bay. They can take these roads faster than we can, so we need to get up ahead, take some serious risks. How about this? About 8 feet wide, that road right there, and this one as well. There's just nowhere to miss.
And now it's Adel and Felix Cruz, Team Foundation in the Dominican Republic. He's emerged after a daring escape down these difficult technical descents, just barreling his way into Charlottesville. No sign of any other rider. Now he's got an impressive 50-second gap over Ramirez, Sanabria, and Rivas.
50.
And Felix Cruz is the first man around that hard right corner. He is on the attack. An incredible steep hill, over 20% grade. Felix Cruz on the attack of his three other escape mates as they'll be coming around that hairpin turn, but looking very good, up out of his saddle, dancing on the pedals. Cruz has decided this is the moment, the Charlottesville climb, that he will go on the attack. So we have Cruz right now on the attack on the foothills of the Charlotte KOM. It's the fourth KOM. We saw how aggressive he was in all the descents. Likely he made up some time and used it as a launching pad.
I think he did an amazing job coming down. He was flying. He broke away from his other three riders, the other two riders that were in the breakaway with him, and he stayed away. And now he's going up this 25% gradient, and he's making it look flat.
Cruz riding alone as we look back down towards Man O' War Bay, a beautiful shot. And completely emblematic of what you get at the Tour of Tobago. High level cycling, excitement, competition, and the beauty of nature in the Caribbean.
Ashley Abach gives us a closer look at the village of Charlotteville.
The village of Charlotteville is located on the northeastern tip of Tobago on Man O' War Bay. The beautiful bays and beaches without a crowd makes Charlotteville one of Tobago's best hidden secrets.
Thanks, Ashley. Back down with Cruz, our race leader, who easily took the Charlotteville KOM, descending now into Speyside, passing the Speyside water wheel on his left.
So we have made the bridge from Charlotteville into Speyside, where Adderley Felix Cruz is riding alone. Beautiful seaside village, Speyside, which now is back on the Atlantic side after spending so much of the Tour of Tobago on the Caribbean side. We've come to the other side of the island, and what a place it is. Some of the best scuba diving you can do out there on Angel Reef.
And now look back at the chase group. They've dropped significant time, about a minute and a half behind Cruz now. They wind along the Speyside coast and get ready to chase Cruz up the Speyside KOM.
This is a group of six riders with Darren Matthews coming off the front at the moment. He does have two Coco's teammates in that group of five behind him, but right now at the moment, it looks like it's Darren Matthews who feels he has the legs. Quick look over his shoulder to see what's going on behind him. Again, that group is now being joined by Herbert Rivas, trying to join that group of five chasing Matthews at the moment.
And now Rivas dealing with a puncture, some quick help from his team vehicle. Meanwhile, the Coco's team vehicle keeping Mauricio Orozco cool in these very hot temperatures.
As Felix Cruz makes his way to the top of the Speyside climb, that's the fifth KOM point of this Tour of Tobago, he will also claim his fourth King of the Mountain. As Adderley Felix Cruz rides beautifully through the village of Roxborough, right on Queens Bay, good crowd of people were out there to cheer him on. He's got a gap of about a minute and a half over his nearest chasers, but he's still got about 30 kilometers to go to victory in the Tour of Tobago 2015.
Our chase group coming through Roxborough, now 2 minutes behind the leader, Adderley Felix Cruz. Cruz is really riding comfortably through Roxborough right now along the cliffs of Queens Bay, and the chase continues behind him. The five-man chase group includes Darren Matthews and Jaime Ramirez of Team Cocos, a couple of former Tour of Tobago champions.
Adderley Felix Cruz has been riding away from his competitors all day long at the Tour of Tobago. He is on the final climb of the day, the Belmont climb. When he summits this, he will be about 5 kilometers to go from the finish line, and he can win the Tour of Tobago. Right now, about a 3-minute gap between a number of very tough chasers.
Beep, 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 beep.
So a group of cows encroaching out into the road, nearly making contact with the leader, Felix Cruz. That's a problem that he got through, but remember, there are chasers only a few minutes behind him.
And as those chasers approach the cows, one of our motorcycle officials, Shannon Medevier, does a great job using his throttle to scare them off the road, just in time for the chasers to pass. Nice camera work, too, from Shannon, sporting the helmet cam.
Adderley Felix Cruz soloing his way to what will be a victory in the Tour of Tobago 2015. 1 year after nearly getting it done, being beaten on a sprint on the Esplanade just before the finish line by Oscar Pachon. This year, Ronald, he got it right.
This year he majorly got it right. Last year he was beaten by seconds. This year he's winning by minutes. It's an amazing ride. He left since Charlottesville and there was no turning back for him. And he put his head down and said, you know what, this year I'm going to win it for my team, Team Foundation. And that's what he came out and did.
Felix Cruz taking his final turn onto the Esplanade. Only a couple hundred meters to go. Celebration for he and his Team Foundation teammates. Adderley Felix Cruz will be the champion of the 2015 Tour of Tobago. The finish line is in sight. He's already given a couple victory salutes from the Dominican Republic. Adderley Felix Cruz, the 2015 Tour of Tobago champion for the Dominican Republic and for Team Foundation.
Now here's the battle for second place. Aurelian Daniel of Team Crown Bakery Knights FR leading out with Darren Matthews of Team Cocos right on his wheel. Matthews loves his position here. Oh, now he goes several hundred meters from the line, and Matthews has made his move, is simply overpowering Daniel here with this finishing kick. The former champion from Barbados. A little professional look over the shoulder here, but there's no one in sight. Matthews dominating and pulls out second place. I caught up with Cruz following the win.
Last year, you came so close to winning this. You lost it in a sprint right here on the streets of Scarborough after making some great moves in the race. How does it feel to now come back and win it after coming so close a year ago?
No, este año vine sumamente muy preparado para esta carrera, ya que el año pasado no tuve la oportunidad de lograr ganar la carrera. Y me siento contento.
Here are the final results for the 2015 Tour of Tobago. Cruz also took the King of the Mountains prize. At the closing ceremonies, Tobago native Emil Abraham, a role model for many Caribbean riders, announced his retirement.
I've had a really good career, and nothing else mattered but to finish my last Tobago International Cycling Classic. I thank you, and good day.
Another Tobago International Cycling Classic in UCI Tour of Tobago is in the books. For Ronald Dickey, Ashley Abach, and our entire crew, I'm Mark Brown. Thanks for joining us.